Hello everyone, I Harshal Desai welcome you all to National CIO Summit, which is being organized by Elex Technomedia Private Limited and the Banking and Finance Post magazine. As most of you are already aware, the Banking and Finance Post magazine is one of the prominent brand in the country that cover anything and everything related to technology in BFSI sector in its bi-monthly editions. We also have a very rich web portal where we cover all these contents, which covers information technology, digital mechanism, cyber security, and several other latest trends and technologies of BFSI domain. Today, we are glad that we are being joined here by a very renowned person from the banking and finance fraternity. He is joining us for an exclusive chat on embracement of new innovative products. Put your for Mr. Sripad Jadhav. He is president and key leadership team member at Kotak Mahindra Bank. Welcome, Mr. Jadhav, to this exclusive chat on embracement of new innovative products at National CIO Summit.
Thanks, Harshal. Thanks for giving me opportunity to talk to you. It is really delighted to be with you here and people like who are well known in this industry, especially on the media, print media, as well as a digital media platform. Nice to interact with you.
Thank you. So, as I have mentioned, the subject is embracement of new innovative products. We all know Indian banking sector is really doing well when it comes to using and adopting new products and technologies to make the customer user experience better. We live in the digital era where technology is driving change in almost every industry, whether it is use of smartphones or automation to improve operations, cloud computing, data analysis, you know, smart use of technology. This is becoming an integral part of the success in every business. And no industry is as driven by technology as banking is, if I'm not wrong. Banks are the leading they're a kind of torch bearer when it comes to use this technology. I had read somewhere that more than 80% of banking CEOs are actually considering the impact of digitization in the finance world. And we will have Mr. Jadhav here with us, who will be sharing his input on these subjects in this exclusive discussion. So, Mr. Jadhav, my first question to you would be that digital transformation, it's helping every sector to grow and run its operation during COVID. So, in your view, how can it help the agriculture sector and farmers during these uncertain times? I would like to start, I would request you to start your conversation keeping the agriculture sector in mind. So over to you, Mr. Jadhav.
Yeah, Harshal, if you really look at India, okay, you are absolutely right. If we really look at the digital way of living, digital has increased in last couple of years. And with pandemic, we were forced to change our course, change our action. Okay, if you really look at it today, meeting somebody is you are slightly skeptical rather than you want to have a video chat or you want to have a phone call with him. And I think so the people have been forced to use a lot of digital things. Now, coming back to the agriculture, I think the majority of the digital, if you really look at it, is a smartphone penetration in India, especially in rural India also. It helps in rural India because the point is, there are distances which are huge where you cannot travel, where the voice or a mobile or a data can travel and you can seamlessly talk to each other based on this. So it is very important for us to have a digital tools which are available, but at the same time, it is very important for a customer to have something to get connected. Without this, digital transformation will not give its output. Today, if you really look at the Kotak as a bank per se, OK, okay, on especially on the agriculture side, we have as on today end-to-end digital acquisition as well as digital servicing model which is in place, which has helped us in this COVID time during the lockdowns, or it is a post lockdown 3 and now the lockdown 4, which is unlockdown 4 is approaching. In that, it is helping us to ensure we give a product delivery to the customer as well as to give a service 24/7 whenever he wants. And it is not so basically today what is impacting. The offices are getting locked down, cities are locked down, but we are able to make the flexible service model which is helping customers from across India. So today there is no place where across India we are shut down. That was the only first 21 days where everything was shut down. And let me tell you, during this 21 days also, by using cloud model, we were servicing the customer even during the lockdown period. I think this is in my lifetime journey, this is a period where I have seen transformation happening at a very fast pace. The adoption on digital side, adoption on video chats, adoption on remote working, adoption on, you know, voice recognition model, everything has gone. So actually this was a time for us to test our all the products which we were running at a lower capacity to utilize the full capacity utilization. And I'm looking at it in a post-COVID era also, because as you know, the new normal, rather than I call it as a no normal, because everything is very different. Today, the way you interact, way you talk, way you trust, way you communicate, way you write, everything has changed. I think in that era, it is very important and it will help our journey, because we embark on this journey. Actually, I think that we were the first bank to get into a product offerings, which is 811, which is a totally digital product. So we were the first to offer and we embarked on this journey. Definitely, it helped us as well as our channel partner to deliver products even in rural India and to the farmers. Because I look at it as a rural products, not only to the farmers, because if you really look at penetration of farmers and other professionals in rural India, is that you know, the gap is diminishing. So it is the farmer on a one side, he is also a professional. So there are combi customer profiles which are coming in this. So we see, right. I mean, if I really look at it versus last year same period and this year, we are actually grown in our numbers.
So thank you, Mr. For sharing your views on how this digital transformation at Kotak is helping agriculture sector and farmers during these uncertain times. One more questions related to this I would like to ask you is, how you are reaching to these farmers with these products and technologies? I mean, you have created some product for the farmers, right? This is the one thing. And reaching to farmer with these products and technologies, how you are ensuring this at Kotak?
See, I will split it at two. Number one is a promotion of the product, and number two is a execution or offering the actual product. Obviously, for a promotion, we are using techniques like video recording, WhatsApp, or the Facebook, because we are also one of the key partners with WhatsApp. We are using social media, and we are using various techniques to reach out to our customers by way of recorded callings, be it virtual bots or anything. Okay. So we are using that extensively. But in rural India, it is essential with you need to have your field team. So it's in the execution. It is not 100% digital. It need to be physical. You need to have 5-10% of your physical presence. And that our national level network, our field teams which are working on the products are helping us to connect and convert customer during this pandemic. So obviously, because though we have a network, but quality of network is always a challenge. So moment you have to upload anything of a 2 MB file, it takes I think hours also in rural India. So you need to have appropriate hub and spoke model. You need to have your representatives there. obviously, I think what you can save is on the underwriting. You can save on the post customer service. You can save something on the documentation, execution, and operational part. So whatever is there at the bank side, we are trying to maximize the digital conversion or digital adoption in that. Obviously, the connecting for doing the documentation, doing field investigation is something which is still you need to be physical, or you can use mobility solutions and all this thing.
Right. What are the typical challenges?
This era, it's not something like it is a total shift to a digital and there is no offices required. Absolutely not. Mm-hmm. You need your people, you need your offices in this.
Right. Great. So what are the typical challenges you face as while reaching to this, reaching to rural part of?
Number one, the point is obviously because of the COVID infections, many few times a part of a city is locked down, few locations, the local government administrative body keeps curb on the traveling. You can't travel district to district. You have a quarantine norms. All these things are impacting the conversion. However, for us, because we have a deep rural network and we are there, on the industry side, one of the indicators in rural India is tractor sales. And you might have heard and read across the newspaper, the industry is booming. So in that industry, we have a market share of 10%. Okay. Right. So that is the penetration level which we have. And we have our own team across India. So that is helping us to overcome these difficulties which we are facing because of this. Right. And obviously, we are there in this for last 16 years. So our customers are also there who are helping us. They have a trust on us, so they are ready to wait for a day or something, and we are able to deliver the products.
Right, great. Now, which schemes run by the center do you think agriculture sector to grow, especially during COVID-19, and how Kotak is and how is Kotak and its farmer centric Kotak's farmer centric offerings are in sync with government's scheme? If you can share some thought on this.
I think first and foremost, the UPIs, the Aadhaars, the various government focus on digitization and direct benefit transfer, and last but not the least, Jandan accounts, which government has done the drive, has actually helped the farmer to get connected during this period. Okay. Now, so these are the things which are already there. Okay. Now, if you really look at it today, what we are doing is we are using, if you really look at a platform, I think cloud and voice recognition has become the backbone for our customer service, query resolution, and our execution on a documentation side. Okay, that has helped us. Number three is, especially for a government side, government has a focus program of a digitization of the land records. I think they are through to 60-70%. In the various states, percentage conversion is on a various scale. But that has helped us because without going to a Talati or a revenue record office, we are able to assess the landholding of the farmer, which is a key asset for the farmer. Number three is we are using a lot of, algorithms which are based on the database, which are based on the, civil record or a bureau record, which you say. And third point is the Aadhaar, KYC based on Aadhaar has also helped. So we in all use all these techniques and we were up running, because if somebody would have decided after COVID, I should start developing, it would have been very difficult. I think that is where we were just ahead of the curve and we were able to use it. Now, what next, if you really look at it? So today, I think the remarkable initiative which government has done, getting direct farmers access to the market, I think that is going to be a big way where farmer is able to improve his income by eliminating the middleman. The APMCs is going down. Second initiative is Enam, where farmer on a mobile phone will get access to the information of various markets which are in his vicinity, and where he can take a, you know, you can say a calculated decision where he want to sell the produce. Third initiative, right, is opening up of the farm sector. Corporates will also start buying directly from the farmers, which will help them to produce what a consumer wants, and it will also boost the export, which is very, very critical for India, because it's not local consumption. India should look at Indian farmers should able to supply for an export, because food export can be a big, big revenue generation or an export for India. I mean, I think that is a focus. And last, the focus on the cold storage and a cold chain. I think that will help farmers to actually improve the income, and you will see farming as a well accepted profession which will come in rural India with the so much of irrigated land available. I think that can be a great journey for making this India as a, you know, the, you can say, a big economy in the world.
Right. E-trading platforms are also very crucial for the, when it comes to marketing agro products, right, for farmers.
Exactly.
How do you how do you see the scope for e-trading platforms for farmers in the country, and what is that we are in which we are lagging behind? Can we say that we have enough e-trading platforms in the country where farmers can make the most of the these platforms and actually grow?
I think there are two things. Number one, anything which is on a trading platform or on the open market will improve the transparency, and it will improve the leakages within the market. So today, when you take a informed decision, it is always better than you are without data and decision. So they will get a better price. Number two is, there is in all the platforms, there is a trust which is involved. Now it is a both the way. It is a farmer to the e-trading platform and e-trading platform to the farmer. Because if somebody is traded, whether there is a stock or not, okay, or there is a produce or not, whether you will get the delivery or not, these are the questions which are there in the mind. I think this product is evolving, and definitely government need to play a crucial role in this, because you need to have a cross check. See, if you really look at now share trading, capital market trading, everything is dematized. You today, whatever get listed on the market, it is certified by some agency. So these aggregators, I think, need to come up, and there is a work which is essential on this platform.
Right.
So especially the delivery is so this trust building will take some time, and there are concrete steps which are required, which today there is a question.
Right. Two more quick questions I would like to ask you, Mr. Jadhav. The startups in the Indian EdTech sector, they are attracting a huge capital. How does Kotak look forward to working with these startups and actually helping together boosting the agriculture sector?
I think, Harshal, you are on the point. I think the post-COVID era, which we called as after Corona, AC world, where you need to be the world of, I call it as a world of cooperations,
yes,
world of joint doing joint work. Because the pace at which the technology and even the everything is changing, where you can't do all on your own. You need to develop on your this thing, and you need a specialized skill, you need a specialized expertise in this. So we are working with the East many startups, and it is helping us to promoting our products. It is helping us to also learn from them on a various aspect of a micro objective. So I see a big role of startups in rural India in coming time.
Right. Thank you. One more thing I would like to ask you. During this two-day conference, we learned a lot on zero trust technologies and artificial intelligence, chatbots, machine learning, and all. Now this question: artificial intelligence is helping you to develop these kind of products, which are very focused for agriculture sector.
See, I look at it, definitely artificial intelligence is a buzzword today everywhere, and artificial intelligence is getting use also. But the more use cases will come after you have a sufficient data, because it is nothing but you need a data for training your computer, you need a data for creating the algorithms. So we are helping artificial intelligence. We are using on two sides. One is underwriting side, second is a fraud prevention side, and a third is a transaction monitoring side. These are the three sets where we are using artificial intelligence based products. I will not say today they are working on their own. We are actually testing it. So you need a human eye observation on that also, because you're not sure about whether you will get 100% result, which will be with the reliability of 100%. So today, there is a reliability issues because of the data availability. So that is what, so I will start. This is a journey which we have started, I think, to convert into the, you can say, day-to-day products, which you can depend on, like a chatbot. Is time, I think it will take minimum some time at least. I will not comment on what is the time duration, because in technology you don't know what will happen tomorrow. So I see a huge introduction of lot of AI based engines in agriculture sector and a servicing or rural customers. I see that happening in time to come.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Yadav. We also look forward to a scenario where Indian farmers make the most of these latest trends and technologies, like many other countries are already doing, right from artificial intelligence to machine learning to Internet of Things. Several technologies in terms of various areas of agriculture, they use them, and we would certainly would like to see those technology coming up in India also. And Kotak Mahindra Bank will definitely have a big role to play in it, strengthening the farmers in the country. So with this, we will formally would like to close this conversation here for the day. And I would now request you for a 2-minute concluding remark on this subject.
So, Harshal, if you really look at a concluding remark, is definitely adoption of digital and products which are digital based products are offering on the both the sides. There is a willingness from a consumer side and there is a willingness from a finances side. So that is a concept which is there to stay. It will help farmers to have a quite bouquet of a product where whatever suited for an individual he can select. So that will be informed decision. With such an open consumerism, I feel the cost of the products will also go down. And for a banks also, the losses will go down, because you were able to monitor the end use for a particular agriculture activity or agriculture farmer or an individual. Or I am saying that it is a non-agriculture products also. So that will help us. So overall, I think we are heading for a better prospect in a future time. And as with the India has so much of, rural population staying, and we have a availability of resources like water and arable land, I think that is a growth driver for Indian economy.
Thank you so much, Mr. Shripat Jadhav, President and Key Leadership Team member at Kotak Mahindra Bank, for sharing your views and your at this platform. And on behalf of the Banking and Finance Post magazine, we thank you so much for taking time out to participate on this virtual conclave, National CIO Summit. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Harshal, and thank you, Elects. that to giving to have this discussion here, and looking forward to more association.
Thank you very much.